Hi, my name is Avani, and I'm going to give you a 5-minute breakdown of stereotypes of human trafficking. Let's take a look. Look here in our home state of Texas, it's a total of about 313,000 cases that have been reported. So imagine the number of cases that we don't know that haven't been reported. When it comes to numbers, 55% of females have been trafficked and 45% of males. That's almost 50-50. Now, what do those human traffickers typically look like? One of the biggest stereotypes when it comes to human trafficking is that it can't happen to boys, and that it's typically just girls or women who are trafficked. A lot of times, another stereotype can be that the traffickers tend to be just males. Sometimes people don't understand that it can be females, black, white, Hispanic, young, or old. Let's break that down. Okay, so we have number one. He was a former football player at a college and also a juvenile probation officer. He worked with two of his victims while serving as that probation officer. He and his co-traffickers were convicted of sex trafficking of children and conspiracy to sex trafficking people as well. Officials in this case say that they used force, fraud, and coercion to get their victims to perform sexual acts. Number two, you have a convicted murderer who became an ordained pastor. He was married, a father of two, and a grandfather of four, and he was convicted of pimping. Number three, you have a grandmother. Okay, that's a woman, a female. Hundreds of women were recruited from different countries such as Russia and Ukraine and other European countries to work in her hotel in Ohio, actually. She would tell the girls they had debts of, you know, $600 or more, and that had to be paid off from their wages. She took passports, immigration documents, and controlled how and where they lived. Okay, so that goes back to that stereotype that typically people think that when it comes to trafficking, it's just men. But this was a case with a woman. This next case, you have an 18-year-old high school senior. She actually pimped out a 16-year-old sophomore cheerleader who had a learning disability. Okay. At the time, she was charged with promoting prostitution and sex trafficking and was sentenced to actually only 3 years in prison. Number five, you have a volunteer fire captain and 911 dispatcher. He actually committed suicide after being charged with keeping a teenager in his home as a sex slave for about a decade. He had bribed the teenager with money and gifts and made them perform sexual acts. Number six, he was your National Guard commander. He joined the military back in the early 1990s and was deployed early 2000s. And he was married with children, but he was actually found guilty of participating in sex trafficking a 15-year-old girl. And two other men were both later convicted of sex trafficking as well that were working with him. In this case, prosecutors said he paid for sex twice with a 15-year-old girl doing a work trip to Texas. And number seven, you have an owner of a spa. She actually held Chinese women who spoke little English at the business for weeks, forcing to perform sexual acts for food against her will. She was charged with human trafficking and promoting prostitution in the second degree, unlawful restraint in the second degree, cruelty to persons, and then threatening in the second degree. You also have this next guy here. He was an accountant. Okay, he worked a regular 9-to-5 job. What his motive was to keep women in his home for months at a time by pimping them out, raping them, and drugging them with cocaine. So in this case, he traded sex for drugs. He monitored the women by using hidden cameras and GPS devices and forced them to clean his house. Okay. And then number nine, we have a guy who exploited more than 20 women, which were minors in New Jersey, Connecticut, and New York. He lured his victims by promising modeling careers and having luxurious lifestyles, and he forced them into strip clubs and street prostitution. And lastly, we have this gentleman who purchased victims from different areas, and he recruited them for sex trafficking, and they were also minors, and he actually was convicted of sex trafficking of minors and adult women through force, fraud, and coercion. So with this slide here, we wanted to just show you that, you know, traffickers can look like anyone. They can be young, old, you know, black, white, male, female, but that just that goes to show you that traffickers don't have a specific look, but stereotypes of what traffickers can actually look like. So now that we've seen the different types of human traffickers that there are, young, old, black, white, male, female, whether it be labor trafficking or sex trafficking, in a home, in a school, at a workplace, we also want you to understand the myths versus the facts. If you or anyone you know is a victim of human trafficking, below we have local service providers that can be of assistance. It is our jobs, if we see it, to report it. You have your National Human Trafficking Hotline, which is 888-3737-888, or you can text the number 233-733. Thank you for watching.